Setting up Notion database templates can be a game changer for your team's productivity. In this video, I'm going to cover some tips that will help you create templates like a pro. If you've never created a database template before, what you can do is you go to one of your databases in Notion, and then you're going to select this little dropdown next to New, and then you're going to select New Template. Once you select New Template, you're going to come to a blank slate page where you have all of your data empty, and then you have an untitled title for this record. And the way that your team members are going to be able to access this template is either by going here and selecting it, and this would create a new record. As you can see, we just created a completely blank record. Or if they select new here and it's the default, so we're going to move this one to the default, and you can choose for only on the all view, which we're in this particular view here, or you could do it for all views and opportunities. For now, I'm just going to do it on only the all view. And so now when I click new, it goes directly to this in this blank slate. So let's start to edit this template so it can help our team get set up and entering data faster. So we're going to go again to the dropdown. We're going to edit it. And for this example, let's say that for this database, we want every single record to follow a particular naming convention. So let's say that we want it to be product sold slash company name, as I'm building a template in a CRM that tracks my deals and all of my contacts for my business. Here below, you have all of your properties, and you can drag and drop these for whatever ones you deem most important and you want to be at the top. So you're making sure that your team is filling out that data. You also can hide particular data that may not be important for every user while they're just creating a new record. So let's say that we want to hide type every single time. So what you could do here is you click on these little six dots, come here to hide property, and then you have the option to always show, hide when empty, or always hide. Let's select always hide. And then when we go back down here to hide seven properties, you can see that type is now gone. If we wanted to bring it back, simply come up here to type, and we're going to always show. Now, if you want a better view to be able to quickly do all of this, I recommend coming down here, again, clicking the six dots, and then coming to customize page, and you have a great view of all of your properties in this Notion database, and you quickly can go through and determine whether you want to show them or not. One tip here that's going to be very helpful for your Notion is how you handle the relations to other databases here in your template. So here in my CRM, I have some relations to some other databases, and you can see that I've created them as a page section. So I've created them as a page section, so I can easily come here and select it, and then I can quickly link an account. And then if I come here and hit the three dots, then I can show whatever data I want. So we could, you know, add this relationship so I can see that they're a customer quickly. We could also add their website and any other relevant information that you want to see quickly in a view. But be careful about doing this within the template, because for every template that I create from here on out, Google would be linked as the account. So let's remove this, but let's keep that page section. Let's say that you don't like that, then all you have to do is simply come here, customize page, and then you have the option just to show it as a property or minimal. So if we go to property, then it simply creates it here as just a relation that you can add here. But in my experience, I think it's always worthwhile just having it there as a page section. So I'm going to go back and add it real quick by selecting as page section. Then moving on, I'm going to show you an example of what I've already created here for one of my templates, and that is some button automations to help me be more efficient with creating new records. So here you could add certain types of button automations. It could be to create records that are related to other properties, like really quickly. You could also have a series of to-do tasks be populated by a button. There's a lot of different scenarios that you can use buttons, and I definitely recommend adding them to your templates. But to show you what I'm doing here for this template here on my opportunity database, if we hit the edit button, I first ask whether or not you want to create a new opportunity product related to this opportunity. Then we add it to my opportunity products database. When doing that, I also tie this opportunity, this database that we're working in right here, and create that relation. And then we also make some edits in that other database. And then I also have the automation automatically opening that new opportunity product record that we created in that other database. To walk you through an example, let's say that for every new record that we have in the opportunity, we want a particular to-do list to populate. So I'm just going to come here, I'm going to press the plus button, and we are going to add a button automation, and let's do insert blocks, and let's name this one opportunity tasks. Then we can come here, and if we go ahead and we search for the to-do list, we can add a few to-do lists here. So let's say one of these could be, you know, write a contract, talk to sales manager, and get approval on contract. You know, these are just some quick examples of what you can add here. Let's add an icon for it. Let's add this little task icon, select done. And then now whenever I click this, we have those pop up on any of those new records that we're creating. I'm gonna go ahead and delete this example real quick. Then another tip for you to get the most out of your Notion templates is by creating databases and then filtering those databases to be related to this particular record that you're creating. So for all these relations that I have here for opportunity products, account, contacts, tasks, and notes, I've created these related databases, and then I've come in here and then added a filter where this opportunity products database looks at the opportunity field within it and checks whether or not it contains the opportunity that we just created. Same thing goes for accounts here. So we're looking at our account database. We're looking for that exact name. And one quick tip, we have this here. This is the name, account name, type year. If you just select the first one here, if the name was to change to something else, that relation will stay the same. So to show you an example of how this looks like in one of my records, we're just gonna go to this opportunity here, and then let's scroll down, and you can see we have, you know, those opportunity products automatically pulling in here. Then we have that account information, and we have this related task also pulling in. And so I prefer to have this on top of these little nice views, because here on these page sections, if you add more than just a few of these little views here. So let's add last modified by, created by, let's give a title, the account owner. You can see that the view starts to get cut off a little bit. So I think this is just a better way to set up a template to be able to quickly always access all the data that is showing up in some related databases. And then my final tip for you is if we come back to this original one that we started working on together and go to edit, on top of this title here, we can enter some more information that will be preset default. So for example, an opportunity, I wanted to always enter the prospecting stage, so I'm going to enter that. And then let's say I also want the type to always be new. Then if we come back here and we go ahead and we select new, you can see that it's automatically default set to those. So we have that prospecting stage, we have the type is new, and then we have that subject for this database item. And you can create as many different templates as you want for your databases and have different data be filled in based on what type of template it is. That's all my tips for on how to create Notion database templates. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.